right, Shalom, Shalom. All right, these are brothers from the GMS Atlanta Church. I got the brother with me, Aynan, from the GMS Dallas Church, coming back at you with another lesson. You know, this lesson is going to be, the title of this lesson is going to be Spiritual Evaluation. But first and foremost, we want to give all glory, honor, and praises unto Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rechai Kodash. All right, and give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well. Peace, love, salutation to the elect 144 first fruit. Okay? And now we can jump right into it. Without further ado, you know, let's go ahead and we're chopping it up in the spirit. We're meditating on the topic. So, you know, we can start off with 2 Corinthians 13:5. Brother Anna, you can read it, man.
All right, this is 2 Corinthians 13:5. It says, examine yourselves whether ye be in the faith. Prove your own selves. Know ye not your own selves, how that Yahushai HaMashiach is in you, except ye be reprobates?
That's right, except ye be reprobates. But the scriptures right there, it says, know ye not your own selves, all right? It tells you to examine yourself, all right? One of my favorite words ever is the word consider, or you can say consideration. The word consider means to view attentively. So be very attentive to yourself, okay? Before you start judging others, like we might bring out in Matthew the 7th chapter, and we can hold Romans the 2nd chapter too. Before you start judging others, you got to make sure things on your plate is straight too, you know? All right, it says whether ye be in the faith, you got to examine your confidence. You got to examine your confidence in the Lord, all right? You have to be with faith. Examine that. See if you're lacking, okay? We understand what James 1:5 says, if you lack, you got to go to the Lord, pray, ask for things, okay? Spiritual things, spiritual requests, let them be known, okay? It says, prove your own selves, prove yourself, man. Don't just sit there and lollygag and be in la-la land and not actually put forth the effort to prove that, man, you know what? I'm really doing this, you know? I'm putting in the work. I do a video a day, whatever. I link up with the brothers. You know, I actually believe, you know, I see certain things that happen in my life that prove to me that the Most High is real and that I believe in him. Okay. It says, know ye not your own selves. That's right. I know myself better than any other brother. This brother know himself better than any other brother. You know yourself better than any other brother. Use that. Actually use that to your advantage. If you actually critique yourself every single day, you're going to trim, man. You are going to turn. Get that whole John 15:2. And it says, how that Yahushai Mashiach is in you. That's right. Because you opened the door and now he's supping with you according to Revelation 3:20. It says, except ye be reprobates. I'm gonna get the word reprobate and I'm gonna pass it along to you, Aynan. Alright. So this is the word reprobate or reprobates. It's a tis. In the Greek, it says a certain one, someone, sometime, okay, a while. It says let's see what it says. It says any certain diverse, partly. See, it says diverse, certain, partly. That goes into that one scripture in James. We just read it. It's James 3. Where it talks about being partially or partiality, okay? Meaning uncertain, okay? You don't want to be an uncertain individual, and that's what a reprobate is, okay? He's unstable in his mindset. He's uncertain. Don't have that uncertainty. View yourself and make sure you are certain you are in this specific thing of ours, man. You got it, brother.
Come on, man. Hey, this your pod, the volume. I had a precept here, and which is in Yapad Debarium means beautiful words.
Beautiful words,
but really, it probably would be Debarium Yapad because the subject goes before the adjective.
Like Rakak in the Hebrew.
Yep. So Debarium Yapad, beautiful words. This is Psalms 139:23. It says, "Search me, O my power, and know my thought, Asalaki, and know my heart. Try me, and know my thoughts." And, you know, this is I believe it was a Psalm of David. Let me double check. Let me see, Psalms 139. Yeah, so this is the Psalm of David. It's basically a prayer to the Most High, man, asking the Most High. David was asking the Most High to search him and see if there. Well, actually, I'll keep reading. In verse 24, it says, "And see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." All right. So, and you know, he was praying for the Most High to direct his steps. You know, to see if there was any corruption in his mind that was, you know, gonna eventually lead him to go astray from losing faith, all right, or getting weak. Mm-hmm. And you know, that should be the same spirit that we have, man. I mean, you know, there should be a point that you get to where you like, okay, and you see yourself losing faith, you see yourself reading less, doing less, or really just even just having less faith, because that's where it starts at faith. Mm-hmm. You know, just kind of like being more in the world, you know, working long hours, you find yourself more and, you know, getting more and more in the world and reading less and doing, you know, fellowshipping less. Mm-hmm. All right. You really should examine yourself, man.
That's right.
Okay. And see, like, okay, am I really in this thing? Am I really, and you know, and the Most High is going to work with you, but you got to do that first though. You got to examine yourself first. Right. Because you can't be, what's the scripture where we talk about, don't let your conscience condemn you, man. All right.
You want me to get it for you?
Yeah, if we can find, I know there's probably a couple of them, you know, but you don't want to walk around with that guilty conscience. You know, brothers talk about it often. You know, especially the Eldar and Nazar in our camp. You know, he likes to go into trimming. The spirit has him going into trimming, and that spirit is pushed out, you know, amongst Israel, on how important it is to cut off, you know, things of the flesh, man. And it's like, nothing is really just going to be perfect in this flesh. We understand that. All right. But if there's something that's hindering you in this truth from doing more, man, hey, and me, myself included, I'm in this, man, it's time to cut that off, man. It's time to cut it off.
That's right.
You know, we don't want to go back to the old ways that we were in, man. And which is why it's so important to examine yourself spiritually to see if you wish, you know, what, how can you improve? You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
But you got it, brother.
That's right. You don't want to be a dog returning to his own vomit.
Right.
You know, you don't want to go back to your old ways. The scriptures tell you to shave off the old man. You know, going back to Romans, the sixth chapter, you know, to keep trimming, you know. Matter of fact, with that, get John 15:2 real quick, because I said trimming, because that's ultimately what you want to do in the first place. And Salaki, brother, were you done with your precept?
Yeah, that was that was at the end of it. Yeah.
Okay, Con, go ahead, bro.
Con, this is John 15:2.
Mm-hmm.
Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch.
Yeah, so every branch that doesn't bear fruit, he taketh away. What is that? Trimming. Literally. You're clipping a branch that doesn't suffice. That's not sufficient for you. Okay? Go ahead.
Come. That beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it.
That's right. Every branch that bears fruit, he purges it. Meaning what? Ultimately taking care of it. Okay? Therefore, so it can bring more fruit. But anything else, man, just got it. Like you said, brother, got to get that clip, man. You got to get them spiritual scissors, or those spiritual hair clippers, and get that shit off you, man. Real talk,
yep.
For lack of better words. You know, you had a precept, bro?
Yeah, man. It's in, I know it's in 1 John. We're going to talk about if our conscience condemn us not, happy are we, you know. But I'm going to go ahead and get this. I'm going to go ahead and get this in Matthew chapter 7 real quick. So this is Matthew chapter 7. All right. And I'm going to start at verse 7. It says, I'm sorry, verse 1. Matthew 7:1, it says, judge not that ye be not judged. Mm-hmm. Now, Christians like to take that scripture and run with it and say that's the end all be all, but
yeah.
There's balance, you know, because the scriptures also say that that the right the righteous men are gonna judge the earth, roughly paraphrasing, mm-hmm. you know. Those that are spiritual are gonna judge people, man. Okay? And so we have to judge ourselves first, though. That's why it says, judge not, that ye be not judged. Because if you judge and you found guilty of being a hypocrite, you're going to be judged, okay, according to that judgment that you made. Verse 2, it says, for with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye meet, it shall be measured to you again. Okay? Just broke that down. That point is in verse 3. It says, and why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye? Okay? It says, or how wilt thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote out of thine eye, and behold, a beam is in thine own eye. Okay? So what are you supposed to do if you have a beam? I'm talking about like a big imagine a big old stick in your eye, preventing you from seeing, mm-hmm. but you see with your right eye, or with your left, whatever, you see, somebody got a little, some little gook in their eye, and you're like, hey, nasty nigga, get that shit out of your eye, man. But little do you know, you got a big ass twig in yours. You got to pull that out first, man. Okay? Get that beam out of your eye first, and which means get right first, and then judge first, mm-hmm. and then judge after that. That's spiritual examination. Mm-hmm. We can't go out on the highways and byways cursing out a nigga that we see smoking a blunt. When we go home, we rolling up the backwoods, all right? Or we doing the dabs or whatever that BS,
Yeah.
That's hypocrisy, man. Hypocrisy. That's why it says in verse 5, thou hypocrite, first mm-hmm. cast out the beam out of thine own eye. So casting that beam out of your own eye means cut that flesh off first. Cut off whatever is hindering you first, you see? And then, it says, and then thou shalt see clearly mm-hmm. to cast out the mote out of thy brother's eye. You see?
That's right.
So if you have darkness in your eye, you can't judge. You see? That's why we have to trim. That's because right. if we're going to be judges, we're going to have to get right. Y'all got it, man.
That's right. That's right. That's a beautiful breakdown, bro. Because you got to spiritually evaluate yourself before you yep. spiritually evaluate somebody else.
Yep.
We don't go on the highways and byways and spiritually evaluate the children of Israel without doing it to ourselves first. It starts with yourself, man. And just to, I'm going to get a precept to land back up. You had a precept?
Wait, can I do it?
Go ahead, brother. Yeah, bring
this
your precept.
This is Second Corinthians 5 and verse 17. Mm-hmm. Therefore, if any man be in Yahweh Shah Mashiach, he is a new creature. Mm-hmm. So us being in this truth, worshiping Yahweh Bashim Yahushah, week in and week out, we are new. Don't Romans 12 say, renew your mind daily, where your mind must be renewed, So we just trimming our ways, learning, growing in the spirit, not doing the things that we used to do back in the world, mm-hmm. Mainly every day we're growing older and older. Because coming back to this word, we're babes.
Yep.
We just sitting there. Then we know how to crawl a little bit, then crawl a little faster. Then we might, rise up a little bit and then fall off balance. Yeah. We're like babes, Then I'm going to just continue. It says, old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Mm. So, yeah, being in these things, things become newer and newer every day. When you look up with a brother, train talents. You learn new things. We used to listen to trap music 24/7. Now certain brothers listen to French and Brazilian singers.
Yeah.
With being in this thing, it just changed you.
That's right.
The spirit changes you. And that's all I have to say on it. Yeah,
that's beautiful, bro. Because when you come into this thing, you're a new man. All right. When you come into this thing, you finally start evaluating yourself. Because before when we were Gentiles in the world, we wasn't thinking nothing about ourselves and the offness that we were conducting in. We didn't pay no mind to it. But now we have a sense of fear in Yahweh Bashim Yahushai and we're cognizant of the things we do on a day to day basis. We check ourselves every single day. The word check literally means to come against the king. We're all kings and priests at the end of the day. So you have to check yourself, okay? Daily. That's the best. That's how you're going to trim. What do I do every day? How can I be better every day? How can I spiritually evaluate myself? What am I lacking in? What am I strong in? What are my weaknesses? What are my strengths? Okay? Like we read in 2 Corinthians 13:5, you know your own selves. So you should know these type of things. Ask yourself these things every single day. And whatever you come up with, work on those every day, man. Make them habits. But, hey, brother, I had a precept to that Matthew 7, man. Because you broke that down pretty flawlessly. I have to add on to you, my brother.
So
this is Romans 1:28. And then I'm going to skip down to 32 and then flow into Romans 2. All right. So it says Romans 1:28. It says, and even as they did not like to retain Yahweh in their knowledge, the Most High gave them over to a reprobate mind. There goes that reprobate again. Okay. An uncertain, an indecisive, hesitant, effeminate mind. Okay. So I had to throw effeminate in there because women are reprobates. Okay. Mm-hmm. They're uncertain. Okay.
Well, they're without faith.
They're without faith. They lack it.
They're not confident.
Yep. That's right. They hate themselves. It says to do those things which are not convenient, right? To do those things which are not convenient. All right. I'm going to skip down to verse 32. Who knowing the judgment of the Most High, right, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them. They like to do the wrong things. Okay, and just for the sake of time and the lesson, I wasn't going to read verse 29 and 30 through 31, but those are the things they like to do. Okay, so you're talking about these guys who like to do unpleasurable things and don't like to self-evaluate themselves. Okay, and see what they lack in and what they're strong in. Okay, this is Romans chapter 2:1 now. Therefore, thou inexcusable, O man. All right. Whosoever thou art that judges. Okay. So whoever the fuck you are judging people, right? But like to conduct in these wicked ass actions. We read in Romans 1:32, knowing the judgments of the Lord. Okay. So you know better. All right. You inexcusable. That's why it says inexcusable, O man, whosoever thou art that judges. For wherein thou judgest another, thou condemnest thyself, for thou that judgest doesn't the same things. Like you're saying, bro, we can't go out on the highways and byways and tell a nigga to stop smoking the shit, and we rolling up a backwood after we get home.
Right, Jake got a blunt in his pocket.
Then you know, hey, Jake with the blunt between their ear, you know, shit with a gold tooth in their mouth. Goddamn it, and you doing the same goddamn thing, man. You are inexcusable, and you know the judgments of the Most High. You know, I'm gonna stop at verse 1, because Romans 2 go in talking about hypocrisy, okay? You know, but that's what it is. You judge somebody else for something that you're doing, you're a hypocrite. Why? Because you never spiritually evaluated yourself and started the process of trimming. That's all it is, you know? You got it, brother.
I was going to say that, you know, as much as we try to be conscious of that, not being hypocrites, man, because like you said, brother, the Most High hates hypocrites, man. Yahushua hates hypocrites.
That's right.
The whole chapter in Matthew 23 is cursing out the hypocrisy of the wicked scribes and Pharisees. Mm-hmm. Now, I wanted to bring into remembrance, though, you know, this account in the history. I'm going to just read it real quick.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get directly to the point. This is 2 Samuel chapter 12 and verse 5. It says, and David's anger was greatly kindled against the man. And he said to Nathan,
yep,
as Yahweh liveth, the man that hath done this thing shall surely die.
Yep.
Now, to give a quick backdrop, and I still encourage brothers to read it, but, you know, Nathan was basically telling David about a man,
yep,
that had a whole bunch of possessions. He had a bunch of sheep, and then he went. The man that had the sheep, he went to another man that only had one sheep, and sacrificed it and slayed it and had a feast with it. And, you know, David was mad, man, you know, and he was like, man, whoever did this, he's going to die. Now, little did David know that this, you know, was really applied to him.
Towards him, that's right.
But the thing is, he actually, when Nathan broke it down to him, that, the man that doeth this thing really is you. David, he humbled himself, man. He repented. Mm-hmm. So it's like, we all need mercy, man.
That's right.
We all need mercy, man. Because the sin that David committed was when he committed adultery. First of all, he killed Bathsheba's wife. Mm-hmm. I think it was husband. Uriah, right?
Uriah. Yeah, it was Bathsheba's husband.
Bathsheba's husband. So I think his name was Uriah, if I'm not mistaken.
It was
Uriah. Before that, he had sex with her.
He even lusted on her because he saw her on top of the building.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm trying to remember if he killed Uriah first or if he had sex with her first. But either way, I think he did have sex with her first.
Because he committed adultery.
Yeah, I think he did commit adultery first. I gotta go back and look.
He did.
But he did both things, man. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, matter of fact. Yeah, yep.
Because
in chapter 11, it talks about that.
Yeah,
it talks about when he first saw her. Yep. But you're right. The sin of adultery was committed first because you committed adultery first in your mind, man.
That's what Yahweh Shai talked about. That's right.
So it's like, this thing is heavy, man.
Yep.
Heavy, because that's why David was so humble, man, because the Most High exalted him and made him so successful in all these wars and things like that. But he's still in the flesh, man. So it's like, you gotta be spiritual, man. Like, we all need mercy, man. The scriptures say mercy rejoiceth over judgment.
That's right.
Okay? And so we really gotta have that in our minds. Anytime the Most High could put the Spirit on us, because the Most High put the Spirit on David to do that, man, which is a scary-ass thing.
It is.
All right? Because David is a man of the Lord.
Well, hey, that's the Spirit you said that, man. Because even so, you know, he committed adultery and the murder, but you said the Spirit... The Most High put the Spirit on David to do that. The Most High put the Spirit on David to count the children of Israel. And when you really read that, it says Satan came on and made him do that. You know what I'm saying? But who's Satan taking orders from at the end of the day? From the omnipotent power. So you're right, bro. The Most High put this, it's a scary thing. The Most High can put a Spirit on you to make you a reprobate because you weren't self-evaluating. You know, you weren't checking yourself, you know, you got it, bro.
Nah, I was going to tell you, you had it, brother. I mean, you brought that out in Romans. Did we get that in Sirach 18 and 23?
Matter of fact, let's get it.
Yeah. Because
it's feasible. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And then, did we still want to get that in 1 Corinthians?
No, you can drop that.
Okay.
You still holding 1 Timothy 4?
I found the scripture I was talking about in John, too. First John.
Okay, Con. Yeah. Hold on, Salakia. This is Ecclesiasticus or Sirach chapter 18 and 23. It says that's what you want, right?
We're talking about the prayer before you go to pray.
Yeah, 18 verse 23. It says, before thou prayest, prepare thyself. And be not as one that tempteth the Lord.
Yeah. And go to verse 20.
Come on, verse 20. It says, before judgment, examine thyself. And in the day of visitation, thou shalt find mercy.
Right. Now that's really more on point. The one that we read earlier, that was a scripture that we discussed before we started the video. Mm-hmm. But I just read up. I was like, oh, okay. But this is spot on, man. Mm-hmm. Okay, examine yourself before judgment. Now, if we know that judgment is coming on the earth, how in the hell are we not going to examine ourselves, man?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know? If you don't do it, then you're just going to be caught out there, man. But the time to do that is right now. This is the opportunity to get right, man. All right? This is spiritual boot camp. Okay? And it says, and in the day of visitation, which is going to be that, that's going to be the commencement of that war. All right. I'm talking about actual World War III, and in the spirit, we in a spiritual war now, but I'm talking about high level battlefield every second, man.
Yeah.
Okay. And, you know, thou shalt find mercy. Mm-hmm. So the servants of the Most High are going to eat in that day. You know, when you examine yourself, man, all right, you first see the video and then you examine yourself. Damn, I've been a nigga this whole time.
Cut.
You know what I'm saying? Now what though? How do you react to that? That's the key. And that's the beginning.
That's right.
That's how it starts. That's, you know, and you say, man, I need to go out there, man.
Yep.
I need to start reading more. I need to pray, man. I need to find out. I need to research. Who had that beam in his eye and said, man, them niggas weren't Jordans, man. They doing the same. These niggas got jobs. Mm-hmm. These niggas got ear piercings. You can judge according to the flesh, okay? And the Most High put the spirit on you to be a demon, man.
That's right.
And be a scoffer and scorner. So you choose the side, man. You got it, brother.
But that's beautiful you said that, because you go a chapter back in Sirach 17, it tells you to what? Return unto the Lord and offend less. I think the 23rd chapter, 23rd verse and the 24th verse, they go hand in hand.
Oh, man. Yeah. Read. You want me to read it?
Go ahead, brother. You can.
All right. Let me see. This is Sirach chapter 17, verse 22. Mm-hmm. It says, the alms of a man is as a signet with him. Mm-hmm. And he will keep the good deeds of man as the apple of the eye, mm-hmm. and give repentance to his sons and daughters.
And give repentance to his sons and daughters. All right? You know, that kind of sounds like 2 Corinthians, I want to say 1 and 6, where it says he comfort us in our tribulation, and the same that we are comforted with, we comfort others, you know? Mm-hmm. We go through our tribulation. We have some mishaps back in our lives. You know what I'm saying? But now that we're comforted with what Yahweh Shai left for us, we give it unto others. So what? What does it say again at the end of that verse?
Oh, it says, and give repentance to his sons and daughters.
And give repentance to his sons and daughters. So we go do the same thing. You can keep going.
Verse 23, afterwards he will raise up and reward them, mm-hmm. and render their recompense upon their heads.
That's right, and render their recompense upon their heads. This can go into Isaiah the 10th chapter, I think like verse 22-ish, I think 20, 21 and 22 in Isaiah 10. Because it says, the remnant of them that returned. When you go into the word return, it means to turn back. Repent means the same thing. To come back or to turn back. Be apologetic. That's not how you say it. Yeah. Just be
to be remorseful.
Be remorseful. The water. Yeah. The water. That's gotcha. It. To be remorseful. All right. That's you apologizing to the Lord, man. That's you turning back. You know, you can keep going. I think there's more in it.
Yeah, these Christians done put a bad taste on that word apologetic.
Yeah.
You know. verse 24, it says, but unto them that repent, he granted them return, and comforted those that fall, and comforted those that failed in patience.
That's right. You keep going, bro.
Return unto Yahweh and forsake thy sins. Make thy prayer before his face and offend less.
You see, he says, forsake thy sins. Okay, so once you self-evaluate yourself, spiritually evaluate yourself, you've forsaken the things that were offensive to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. You start following the law to the best of your ability. You start keeping his commandments. You start loving the brotherhood. You know what I'm saying? You start doing these things. You forget the sins, man. Meaning, if you forget sins, you're doing something else. You're keeping righteousness within yourself, okay? And it says you return to the Lord and you offend less, you know? Because when you self-evaluate, you see your weaknesses and your strong points, see what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong, bro, you know? And you will start offending less after that. You know, that's why it's heavy to look upon yourself, to take heed to yourself. You know, did you have something?
No, I was just about to say that's what scripture said. You know, just to keep it short, just be good.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right. It's beautiful. It says that in the book of Titus, the second chapter, speaking about the aged woman. But who's that aged? We the woman.
Yeah, we're right. Outside woman.
We're the woman. So literally, Titus, I know it go after the aged woman starts talking about the young man, but both. It's talking, the whole chapter is talking about us. We're that woman, okay? We got to be good, be discreet, you know what I'm saying? Be chaste, if that's how you say it, you know?
Yep.
That's how we supposed to be.
Because once you continuously examine yourself, you basically, at the same time, washing yourself too, daily, you know? And once you're washing yourself daily and trimming your ways, your house shall look at woman like, look good, you know.
Good.
Then you start burning incense and all right, smelling good. Mm-hmm. Man, I might just come that saver, man. You know,
yeah.
That's basically how it is, you know.
That is. That's a good point.
Yeah, just be good. She ain't being a bitch no more. She ain't going out there
whoredom.
Yeah, worshiping other idols. Being niggas, you know.
Yeah.
So that's just basically what we're doing, man. You know.
Yep.
And that's all I have to say.
That's a beautiful point, man. Because that's what it is, you know. Do you have a precept right now?
Con. Let me go ahead and I just moved my finger. Oh no. We gonna read this. I know Jake moved a finger. Sirach 18.
Okay, Con.
Yeah,
Sirach 18. Oh, you want me to read it for you? Keep going.
Read. Let me see. Well, let's just read 23 again.
Okay, Con.
And I have one more.
All right, Con. So it says, Sirach, or Ecclesiasticus, chapter 18, verse 23. It says, before thou prayest, prepare thyself, and be not as one that tempteth the Lord.
Right, so before you pray, man, all right, and I wanted to make this point because, like I said, it popped up in my head. The Spirit wanted to come out in this lesson that you gotta humble yourself, man. I mean, you really have to realize who you're talking to. Like, if you just go up to your boss and just tell him anything, like, oh, I ain't coming in tomorrow, or even just look at him or talk to him nonchalant, or some certain things, man, brothers, we got certain, I'm using the boss as an example because that's an authoritative figure, but, you know, if you had a father figure, all right, in your household when you grew up, okay, and you just being a bad little nigga, man, you know, he'll be like, straighten your ass up quick. How much more the Most High, man? How much more the Most High? Okay, that's we got to keep that in our mind.
That's right.
The utmost respect that we can conceive needs to be given to him. Okay, at all times. All right, you don't want to get too familiar and too relaxed when it comes to praying, man, because the words that you're saying are definitely getting looked at seriously.
Yeah.
Okay, when you send that petition up to the Most High, and that's, you know, that, like I said, that's why it says. It says in verse at the end of verse 23, and be not as one that tempteth the Lord. You know, you don't want to ask for the wrong thing. You don't want to be too, you know what I'm saying? You know, you don't want to be carnal, man. You just got to just keep it spiritual, man.
Yeah.
You know, and then I'll go ahead and finish it out. Unless a brother had another one, I'll just read this real quick. This is scripture in, First John, chapter 3.
Mm-hmm.
And, I'll do verse 18. I'll start at verse 18. It says, my little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth. Okay, so you have to spiritually evaluate yourself and make sure that you are doing the things that Yahweh Shai told us to do. Okay, and it says, so not loving in word only by saying, oh, I love you, brother, but actually showing your love by picking a brother up, taking him home, you know, certain things, you know, helping a brother out when he need help.
Yeah.
Okay.
Love is a verb. It's an action word.
Yep. Agape, you know, which is the same word as charity in was it 1 Corinthians 13? Mm-hmm. You know, or 2 Corinthians 13. Anyway, it says in verse 19, and hereby we know that we are of the truth, and shall assure our hearts before Him. If our heart condemn us, and our heart and our mind is synonymous, you know, So it really, that's your conscience. If your conscience condemn us, or I mean, it's you find yourself guilty. Condemn mean guilty. So if you have a guilty conscience, okay, the Most High is greater than our heart and knoweth all things. The Most High can actually, you know, put the right spirit on you to get you right. Okay, verse 21, it says, but that requires prayer. By the way, I throw that out there too. Verse 21, it says, beloved, if our heart condemn us not, then we have confidence. Okay, then we have faith towards the Most High. Okay, and we are able to maneuver in this world and preach and prophesy when we're in out in the highways and byways and do our lessons in confidence, knowing that, you know, the Most High, He trying my heart. He knows that I'm right. You know what I'm saying? And so it don't matter. The Most High is our witness. Yahweh Shimei Shai is our witness. Okay? Just like how Yahweh Shai said it. You know, he said, my witness is true, but one that is greater than me is my witness, the Most High. You know? And so when we walk in that confidence, we're actually able to spiritually execute things in our daily life, okay, and you know, in this ministry more efficiently. Okay? Mm-hmm. But that was it. That's all I had, bro.
Man, that's beautiful, man. I'm gonna get that word condemned for you in that.
Okay.
Word condemned in the Greek is it's a kata genosko. Let me see how Esau says it. Shit.
Fuck that up. Strong's G 2607. Kataginosko. Kataginosko.
Kataginosko. All right. It says to find fault with. What is that? That also sounds like you're convicted in your spirit.
You know? Yeah.
Blame to accuse and condemn. Mm. That's right, man. That was a beautiful precept. You know? That was a beautiful precept. Shoot, man. Matter of fact, with that, because that was a beautiful breakdown of we could close that out on that. You know? But, you know, the point of the matter is to spiritually evaluate yourself. You know? And make sure that certain things that you're doing in the faith is what's it? Certain things that you're doing in the faith is feasible in the sight of the Lord, man. And you gotta notice certain things that you're doing in the truth that might not be feasible or expedient in the sight of the Lord too, man. You know, but like the brother I now was saying, that comes with a lot of that comes with a lot of prayer and supplication added with that coming to the Lord, man. Did you have any closing remarks?
Hey,
Nas, you have any closing remarks?
Hey, man, just pray Most High. How about Shemesh? Shall keep the spirit on us to keep enduring, you know?
That's right. You know, that's the only thing we can do. It says hold fast until He comes. So that comes right with a lot of endurance and patience and long suffering, man. So, you know, with that, we want to give all glory, honor, and praises unto Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem, HaKadosh. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of great millstone who rule well. Peace, love, salutation to the elect 144 first fruit. Again, these we're the brothers from the GMS Atlanta Church. We got the brother, the beautiful brother, Aina from the Dallas camp. I know, Lord willing, this lesson was edifying. Until next time, we want to say shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom.